Yeah, it's pretty clear that the MDGs will not be reached by 2015. And that has more to do with the discourse that we have about the MDGs than with the course of progress that we are looking at. The discourse has been about more the traditional elements of more aid, more economic growth, and more good governance. What has been missing from the discourse is the fact that our global trading system is not fit for purpose for the MDGs, and that inequality within developing countries has grown so fast that it's making the MDGs mission impossible. Some are succeeding, the others are failing, the MDGs, mostly because of initial conditions. And that's the most widespread misunderstanding about the MDGs. The MDGs are not meant to be reached by each and every country. They are collective targets. They have to be met at the global level, not at the individual country level. Because it's clear that Africa is not going to reach the MDGs, because Africa started from a very low level of human development. So for them to reach the MDGs is a very tall order. And so the MDGs were never meant for Africa. They were meant for all the countries together. And so when people say Africa is missing the targets, I am saying no, Africa is not missing the targets. You are missing the point. Well, the new donors are always welcome, of course. And it's good that the countries that are emerging are taking their global responsibility. The way they do that can be criticized, and this is the case for China in particular. But I'm not going to get into there. But the good point is that Brazil, India, China are taking their responsibility, and that's good for the world, and that's good for the MDGs. What we are seeing in North Africa and in the Middle East is basically the fact that our traditional discourse is not working. Those countries have seen good macroeconomic performance over the past 10, 20 years. They have seen good progress macroeconomically, but it hasn't translated into real living conditions for real people because of growing inequalities and joblessness. And this is what we are faced with. This is not about a democratic movement. This is about people saying enough is enough. I want to take part in the benefits, the macroeconomic growth, and I want a job. Most people agree that the MDGs have been a good thing, and they want a similar overarching framework beyond 2015, most of them, the 90%. They all have problems with the way the MDGs are shaped, but they all say this is something that is useful. So it's very likely that we will have another framework, another set of goals and targets. Of course, the question then is, how do you structure it? And how does it look like? I do not want to recommend how it should look like, but I have my ideas how it should be done. And this time around, it should not be another exercise in donorship. Because the current agenda that we have, the current MDG set, is very much the result of a donor dialogue and a donor-centric view of the world. This time around, I hope the UN or the multilateral agencies can set up a process where a group of people from the South, led by the South, with some people from the North, but from the South, put their agenda on the table. Lula can preside it. He's out of a job. President Lula from Brazil, he can lead the process, but people from the media, from the music world, from the business world, from academia, a wide group of people, maybe half a dozen, mostly from the South, have the next 3 or 4 years to go around the world, talk to yourself and other many people of how do you want this MDGs to look like next time around, and then put something to the table. And I hope this will happen this time. Well, the EU has taken the MDGs really too hard, especially on their responsibility vis-à-vis development assistance, which is great. We have had commitments made towards 0.7. We have seen an increase in donor support in many EU countries, especially in Spain, in the last 10 years. EU will not meet their own targets of the 0.7, But that's okay. I'm not too concerned about that. What the EU still has not internalized is that their commitment goes beyond the 0.7. It's more than a donor-centric debate. And the EU is still very much hanging on to a global trading system that is not fit for purpose. The EU is still sticking, and especially with the Economic Partnership Agreement, the EPAs, they are not fit for purpose. They do not help countries in the South realize the MDGs. And that debate has to really come to the EU and to Brussels, and to say maybe we should change our approach to copyright, to patent laws, and to our global trading system.